Welcome to another Unturned video. Today I'm going to go solo in a Polaris PvP server on normal mode. Now this server was during a playtest of Polaris, meaning that the map wasn't public yet and a couple of items did change. The server will be completely vanilla, no plugins, no TPA, none of that. If you guys enjoyed this video and want it to become a series, where in the future we will get into more PvP and the endgame of Polaris, make sure to drop a like, let's aim for 500 likes. Subscribe if you haven't yet, a huge percentage of you guys watching right now aren't, so I would really appreciate it. Last video I announced a mythical giveaway and this is the winner. To claim your prize, please join my Discord and contact me there. Also, today we're going to roll another one. To enter this mythical giveaway, make sure that you've liked, subscribed and comment whatever you want below. And the winner will be in the intro of the next video. Also, channel members have a higher chance to win, and if you're interested in becoming one, the link is in the description below, as well as in the pinned comment. I'll be recording a survival series on my Polaris servers, so feel free to play there. The IP ports will be in the description below, and let's get straight into the video. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we are in Polaris. Now, I did play on Polaris a bit, like on single player for 10 minutes, but I barely know anything about this map. But we're on the server, and obviously when you do spawn in, you spawn in at like low tier areas. If we hit these, we get items if you didn't know. But we're gonna salvage these, make them into cloth. I can even craft myself a chart, by the way. Which is pretty cool. Got ourselves a hunting knife, and if we hit these, yeah, we got armored plates already. I'm pretty sure that's something important. I don't know if these actually will drop anything else. It seems like it's just fishing items, yeah, fishing clothes. Now, this server, I'm pretty sure I also did announce it in the intro, but it is a playtest server. Currently, there aren't people on, but later on, they will be. It is quite early in the morning, and I do want to get myself a head start. I will be trying to raid bases, obviously, and progress Polaris fully. Yeah, got ourselves some XP, so... Yeah, we can equip armored plates, by the way. I think we can place them down, then. Alright, so I'm gonna go up this tower. I have no idea what you can get from here. Hopefully something good, man. Alright, well, it looks like, yeah, firefighter clothes, some metal. Now we'll switch that instead of the torn shirt. Oh, this is just spawned as well. Perfect. Alright, yeah, I can make myself splints. Metal. Alright, we can't open that. Alright, so from this area, I assume that you can only just get firefighter items. So maybe even, like, gas mask items, we can get them from up there. We'll keep that in mind. And this looks like a military area. Okay, that's pretty good. An unmarked military location. Hopefully get ourselves some weapons. I do know of a couple of weapons from here. I do know of a gun named the Walnut, which is like the main weapon people will use. Yeah, get ourselves a military shirt. We'll switch that. We'll salvage this flashbang, jerry can, flashlight. I'm gonna pick up everything, man. We'll salvage them if they're not useful. And we got ourselves a better knife, I assume. Alright, we'll salvage these, salvage that. And we can put them into metal sheets, I'm pretty sure. And we can stack cloth into rope. If we hit these, we can get ammo. And I'm pretty sure we can get weapons as well. Grenade, let's go. Oh, this dude dropped night vision. Okay, that's pretty good. I did not expect night vision to be dropped by a normal zombie. And we made ourselves a backpack as well. We can craft that. Let's make ourselves some dressings. Still no weapon, unfortunately. We got ourselves a parachute. Let's go. Yeah, some ammo, more knives. We'll salvage everything because we're gonna need metal. We got ourselves a B3 compensator. That's pretty good. We'll make them into metal sheets. And I'm pretty sure with sheets, we can make them into cans. It's like a really good stacking method. There's an MRE here as well. So I'm currently in like a hospital area. Yeah, scrub tops. Dude, I accidentally salvaged the parachute. Rip. Splint, cotton wool splint. I think with these, can be made into cloth. Yeah, they can be made into cloth. Man, I'm just trying to get a weapon most of all. We got a saw as well. Oh, we got ourselves a pistol. We got the block. We can even equip melees from our inventory, meaning we don't even have to put them in primary or secondary. It's kind of good. What is this, a quest? Pizza? Yeah, I just need 2 tape and we get ourselves a pizza shop. Alright, so our inventory is starting to get a bit full already with just like random items. It's not even anything that important. A lot of metal, a lot of cloth. So in here, it seems like it's a construction area. Yeah, we got a tape. Oh, we got another weapon. Wait, it just despawned. Never mind, we just lost that weapon. Alright, so we can even make med kits. And we made ourselves a bed. And we put all of the metal to sheets. And we got ourselves a copper coil. Okay. Well, I don't know what this is. Alright, let's kill him. This gun's actually an auto pistol. Alright, so is this the ammo for it? No, it's not. Should I just kill him with a melee? Oh, and he almost killed me. Yeah, I'm about to die. Yeah, well, don't do that. Was kind of stupid. How the hell am I gonna kill him then? I need to get myself some more ammo or something then. So there's a farming area here. Probably won't get anything good from here though. And salvage all of these clothes. Oh, we hit these. We actually can damage it. Oh yeah, it gives wood. That's pretty cool, man. Like, I assume if we have a chainsaw or something like that, it would be much quicker. Yeah, it takes 4 hits with this. Okay, wood. And we can even pick up that metal. So cool, man. Yeah, I got myself 3 wood from that. Alright, so perhaps I can actually start trying to build a base zone. Alright, anything good from here? What is that? Slugs. Oh, more metal. We'll take those. And even... Okay, well, we got ourselves wheat as well. What is that? A flare. Okay. There's an axe here. We got ourselves an axe, too. Then we got ourselves the perfect melee to build a base. Well, there is this truck here. We need a military drive. Alright, we'll keep that in mind. I have no idea how to get one. Alright, so I'm going to go build close to a location called Haze. I don't know if it's a good location, but I feel like it's an area where we can actually be close to everywhere. So I farmed wood for quite a while, and we can actually stack them into logs as well. So 4 wood is 1 log. We'll build the base somewhere around here. For now, I'm just gonna do a 1x1 full wood. Yeah, we need, it's not that much. We only need 2 wood for a pillar. Yeah, I like how this looks as well. Now, we need to get ourselves more wood, obviously. We only had enough to make the foundation and pillars. We're gonna place the bed here. Let's go. Yeah, and each tree pretty much drops like 4 wood, so it drops 1 log. Which kind of does make sense. And there is a beret here. We got ourselves a black beret. Alright, I will wear that. Alright, let's stack these. Because I am full. I can actually make them into walls already. Yeah, we got ourselves 2 walls. Alright, and the base is pretty much done. All I need is a door. Which, in order to make a door, I need 4 scrap or 4 wood. 4 scrap shouldn't be a problem, actually. Can just salvage, I don't know, the saw. Bam. Easy. Yeah, a couple of people did start to join as well. They're bandits and all of that, so they are experienced in this map. Oh yeah, we got ourselves scrap door. We needed crafting one in order to do that. I'm gonna get myself some logs in order to make storage as well. And there's something down here. We'll check that out later, though. I'll place the door right over there. Now we can decompress those. And in terms of lockers, I need to make... Alright, so the main lockers are called scrap lockers. Alright, oh, okay, I only need 4 scrap for this. That's pretty good. That's actually extremely cheap. Yeah, even the logs, they can be placed. Oh, that's pretty nice. I'm gonna make myself some more lockers. Yeah, we can make ourselves 2 more already. Alright, this one dropped on the floor and we'll place that right over there. And there we go. I'll put some items that I don't want to lose in here. We'll put all of these and we will go continue loot around. Now we can compress these into a hay bale. Okay, but we need way more. Put the MRE, the armor plates. We cannot put this in here. There's no soil. Makes sense. Copper coil. Alright, we're gonna go loot Haze now. I don't know what's going on. Okay, we got Siren Crystals. But there's like a zap from an electric zombie. Like the boss zombie. I don't know what's going on over here. Alright, well, I found this. I assume this is Haze. Alright, let's check out what we get from here. This looks like a biohazard area, to be honest. There's a lot of zombies, actually. It's alright, though. We'll kill them all. Bro, there's so many. They're literally over here. Oh, Haze top. What are they dropping? Oh, ammo. Okay. I think that's for my pistol. It's 9mm. Yeah, they're starting to all die out, finally. Yeah, each of them gives 3 XP. Alright, and we have cleared them out. Alright, well, we got ourselves... Okay, well, if we salvage these, we get biohazard fibers. We can make them into biohazard rolls. Okay. Cancel the 9mm box, 9mm, scrap metal, and biohazard fibers. Yeah, we could refill this. 20 shots. Haze helmet. Actually, I will still be running around with the beret. I don't know, looks cooler. Let's salvage these. Alright, there's more ammo. Oh, we compress this into a biohazard troll. Now, what will we do with that? Oh, we can make ourselves a hood. Okay. Gas mask. Alright, so we need to farm haze then. It's a good thing that we came here then. There's a weapon in here. What is that? Rectal snake. Okay. Comes with a laser. Let's check out what's up here. We might need night vision or something like that, though. There's another gun here. What is that? A blicky. Alright, it's like, seems like another pistol. Haze vest, biohazard trolls. Let's salvage that. 9mm box. Alright, this area is not too bad. Seems like it's a mid-tier loot area. Alright, let's fill up the boxes. Yeah, we've pretty much looted down here. Let's check out what's up here now. Let's switch on our night vision. Haze bottom. Yeah, we hear that electric thing again. Well, with the blicky head, we'll salvage that. We don't need that. It had a tactical light. Now, where the hell am I going? 9mm box. Grape juice. Nice. Alright, so we need to farm these, man. We need to salvage all of the clothes. Oh, yeah, there is a boss zombie. Wait, can you kill him, though? Yeah, he can't hit me through here, thankfully. I can maybe make myself a ton of meds. Oh, yeah, we can kill him. Oh. Well, I might die. I don't know how strong this guy is. Yeah, he will hit me, definitely. Oh, let's med up. Bro, I don't think I was supposed to find him this early, actually. Oh, no, he's dead. And he dropped a military drive. Okay. Wait, that's the thing we needed for the... for that truck, right? Alright, progress, progress. So, if we go up here, where the hell do we get? Another haze top. Oh, I think I know where we're gonna arrive. Oh, yeah, we're here. And I broke my leg. and I'm bleeding. Nice. Let's make ourselves a splint. All right, let's go back to base. Now, my base is somewhere around here where the airdrop mark is. So I'm currently looting another area called intelligence. I think it's a police area. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna get anything that important from here. Field knife, hockey, that is three. Yeah, there's shotgun ammo. Oh yeah, there's a shotgun. Okay, we got ourselves a shotgun. That's pretty good. Glasses, what? Oh, we can wear them as, okay. That's kind of cool. Alright, this gave us another shotgun. Okay, well, at least it's 100%. Oh yeah, we've looted here. Nothing too special though, just shotguns. There's something in here, open. What is that? Another military drive? Okay, well, we got through. Well, there's a missile base over here. It's armored as well, I think. And we are currently where the military base is. It's called Fort Evergreen. Yeah, maybe Mega Zombie spawn here and we get ourselves some high tier loot. 9mm ammo. Yeah, flashbangs. We don't need those. Get ourselves a balaclava. Tank trap. Oh, wait. Dropped an elite spec. Hey, yo. Upgrade. Right, it's good to know that normal zombies drop elite specs. I'm kind of scared that people might be around here. Oh, yeah. And I got the military drive on me, right? So maybe we can put this in here. Polaris rose, copper coil, and crystal. Okay. Well, we need those to put them in there. And I assume we get something in return. Alright, yeah, we're full military now. All we need is a vest. Oh, there's a vest right there. Perfect. That's all we needed. We're full military now. There's a military helmet. Yeah, they give the same armor, man. So I did pretty much loot the whole area. We did not get any new weapons, unfortunately. But I got myself quite a ton of grenades, ton of metal, ton of components, and we got full military. So I'm gonna run back to base depot. Oh, I dropped a weapon. What is that? A kinney. Okay. And ammo. Alright, so till now I have no idea what is a good gun or what is a bad gun, so I will probably just take them all. And then from PvP I will just try to tell. In this map I'm noticing there's a lot of unmarked locations. Like, there's another police area over here. All around Fort Evergreen, by the way. Oh, he dropped, what is that, 5.56 ammo? I think that's like military ammunition. We got ourselves a police top, we could salvage that. Police bottom, we could salvage that as well. Is that a nightstick? We'll salvage that. Well, till now, I feel like we're getting ourselves some pretty good progress. So I found another unmarked location, which is a haze location, so we can get ourselves even more fibers. Which is currently what we need in order to progress to get ourselves a gas mask. Oh yeah, I'm stacking everything. There's another blicky over here. There's a bunch of more areas, there's a bunch of more tents as well over here. Another vest. Oh wait, we fly! Oh my god, that's so cool! That's so sick! It could be so funny when you're doing PvP against people, man. We got ourselves more copper coil. There's two over here, man. That's kind of good. Oh, there's another shotgun. It's called a ball. I have not seen that before. Yeah, I need to drop some items. I want to get this. Yeah, I might need to leave some ammo over here. Maybe let's fill up some ammo. And we should be able... Yeah, that one's empty. That one's empty as well. Yeah, my inventory is full, man. I should probably head over to base. I've been saying that for so long, but I'm not doing it. Because I keep going in different locations. Currently in this town... it seems that it's pretty good. We got ourselves some good items. There's a fire station over here. Maybe we can get ourselves like filters or something like that. But there isn't any right now. Oh yeah, there's these things over here. Let's kill him. Yeah, if we get too close, he will actually damage us. That gives 10 XP, damn. And he dropped... Oh, cyan crystals. Okay. Now this is how we get cyan crystals easily then. We need to drop something for this. So let's drop one metal scrap. Alright, now we should definitely head to base. We are finally back in base. What a really, really good loot run. I'm really happy with this. I'm gonna make myself some more lockers, obviously. Yeah, we need more metal. Alright, we got ourselves two more. We placed one right over there. Second one there. Let's start putting the guns. Stretzel snake, kinney. The fibers, the shotgun. Now, in terms of a horde, okay. Well, we need a generator. Yeah, we could make it. All I need is a generator. And to make a generator, I need metal. I need a couple more scrap. We can decompress the can, make them into metal. We got ourselves a generator, and we got ourselves a horde. Nice. Well, that was easy. Alright, we'll put everything we don't need in here, and we'll go do the horde at the closest area. Ourselves a ton of rope. Alright, we'll put the metal in there too. Yeah, I'm gonna put everything I don't need. So, if I die by somebody, hopefully not, they wouldn't get everything, you know? I don't need Okay, well, it only summons 25 zombies. I did not know that. So, we probably won't get that much good items. Alright, so I'm gonna place it over here. 25 zombies shouldn't take that much, actually. We could literally just shoot them down. Since I'm solo, it's taking what? It's taking 2 headshots to kill him. And there's construction zombies as well. With the helmet, so they might take a bit more shots. Yeah, first box. I already hear the mega zombie. Yeah, dude, he's already dead. Heart beacons on this map are... Wait, it broke. Wait, there, nothing spawned. Okay, well, I think it either bugged. Yeah, probably bugged. Okay. Well, that was a bit of a waste. Thankfully, we didn't really need that much items to craft it. What is that? There's another gun here. Grit. Well, I'm kind of disappointed, but it's okay. Again, the map... We're still playtesting it, so I'll just report it. That's probably just a bug. Alright, so I'm back at Haze. I need to farm those biohazard fibers. I'm just gonna shoot them down, man. Yeah, it was way quicker. Alright, yeah, we did get a couple. I'll salvage everything. Salvage the metal sheets. And will you go kill that boss zombie once again? Maybe he can drop something else than a military drive. There's another rattlesnake here. Let's get it. They're a pretty good weapon, man. I actually do like this gun. Alright, it takes, I think it's like 2 mags. I already put one into him, yeah. A grenade launcher, okay. Got ourselves something else, yeah. I don't know if these raid or not. Oh, dropped a weapon as well, okay. Alright, so there's a windmill here. Oh, well. No power. Alright, let's see what's at the top then. Oh, wait, what? Enable power. Oh, okay. We've enabled power. Alright, wait, what's gonna be in here then? Well, that's kinda cool, it opens like that. Oh, oh, we're in the safe zone. Oh, okay, what are these? I think these are different entrances to the safe zone. Yeah, there's a guy here. Oh, there's 2 people in here, hello. Alright, well, in here we're gonna get our quests then, I assume. Executioner. Alright, yeah, this is a zombie quest. You just need to kill zombies. He gave me a sandwich. I'll take that. Thank you very much. There's a dancing penguin in here. That's kind of cute. Yama. This dude. Okay, Absorber slain. I think that's the dudes that we shoot. We need a Moses for this dude. Bernard. Well, I assume this is going to be the main boss in terms of quests. Yeah, he just vanished. Nice. Is there anything up here? Nope. Oh, this dude, we can get ourselves some items from there. Yeah, we can get ourselves a blowtorch. There's a fisherman here. Yeah, we need to open those fishing crates. I've already done that when we started the map, so that's kind of easy. This dude. Oh, beret reward. Okay, well, we can get ourselves rewards for finding berets. That's pretty cool. Now, this dude, vending machine. ATM. Oh, wait, we can deposit money? Withdraw. Yeah, we deposited money. Okay, well, I assume then we can buy stuff. There's a farmer quest. We got ourselves 0 quid, though. Man, I'm quite confused. So, if we withdraw. Yeah, we put 100 bucks in the ATM. Yeah, deposit. So, now we can buy? Oh, yeah, okay. Yeah, we can buy, like, a wrench, a generator. I'm not gonna buy anything, though. We don't really need those items. Yeah, we can sell metal, we can sell rope. And there's a dude here. Oh, the safe zone doesn't even show on the map, so I don't know exactly where we are. So, if we press on any of these, it's where it'll take us. Oh, yeah, we're at the cave. Alright, yeah, okay, well, I have no idea what this is. Oh, that's so cool. Right, we'll turn them all on. You're out of the safe zone. Oh, yeah, that's very cool that there are various entrances to the safe zone, actually. I assume there's another entrance. There's a waterfall here, man. It's so nice. It looks like there's another haze location down here. There's another observer here. Let's kill him. And we would finish the quest, I assume. Yeah, you got ourselves another cyan crystal. Yeah, and the quest is done. And I think once we finish it, we all get ourselves another cyan crystal. So that's double the profit. Well, there's a hole here. I think... Wait, do we die if we go down? No, we don't. Well, there's a whole, like, sewer system down here, man. Oh, a walnut? Okay. Enable power. Yeah, I think there's another entrance to a safe zone then, probably. Well, there's a pickaxe here. Let's take that. And yeah, we can farm metal. Oh, it's one hit. Okay, well, that's easy. Wait, it's not one hit. Oh, that's so cool. Each time we hit it, you get metal. Imagine with a jackhammer then. Alright, so the small ones, we get them with one hit. Alright, anything good from these? No, just shotgun ammo. Dropped a sniper. What is that? A Merlin. Okay. Oh, there's a guy coming. Oh, he's dead. Alright. Okay. He has some items. Jackhammer, some ammo. Bunch of food by the looks of it. He has a Moses too. I think that's for the quest, if I remember correctly. Yeah, laser, some attachments. Okay. Hey, first kill on Polaris. Let's go. And that is it for episode 1. I really hope that you guys did enjoy. If you guys want episode 2 to come out where we continue, let me know in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.